Can't you understand that I'm truly, genuinely sorry, Dad?
No, sorry doesn't change anything, and it sure won't get you out of this mess that you've made for yourself. For all of us.
Why do you hate me?
Where do I even begin, Sean? And by the way, I don't hate you. I just hate what you've done. I'm honestly ashamed to even freaking call you my son.
Wow, I can't believe that you just said that.
But it's the truth. What the fuck else am I gonna say, Sean? You become an embarrassment, not only to me, but to the whole family. You sit around here all day and you don't do shit. You don't do jack shit around here other than play video games all day with your loser fucking friends. I mean, when are you gonna grow up and become a man, Sean? You don't have a job. You sat with your mother and I and told us that you don't wanna go to college. You don't have a girlfriend. You don't wanna play any sports. You don't have any hobbies, no goals, no dreams, no ambitions, nothing. I mean, honestly, Sean, I feel nothing but shame when I think to myself, this is my son, this is my boy, who's always going to be a fucking loser, and who's never going to amount to anything in life.
I'm glad that you think that, Dad. I really am. Can't wait to keep making you proud.
You're unbelievable, Sean. I mean, how could you be so stupid, so irresponsible and incompetent that you couldn't do the one thing, the only thing that I asked from you, huh? You had one job, Sean, and that was to take care of your sister the one night while we were away. You couldn't even do that!
Dad, I didn't mean for any of this to happen.
Well, it did! And now you gotta face reality. Your little sister is in the hospital and she's gonna die because of you. Don't try to convince me otherwise. She's gone! And no hospital or doctor is going to change that fact. I want you to remember that, Sean. You took your little sister, my daughter, from me. You let this happen. Now you've got to live with that for the rest of your life, whatever the fuck you decide to make of it.
I need you to understand that this wasn't my fault.
Oh, really? You don't think that negligence isn't something that makes you accountable? Huh? How does that work, Sean? Your sister goes out to play for less than 1 minute. You can't even look after her properly to the point where she gets run over by a car trying to cross the street. Tell me, how is this not your fault?
She wasn't playing. She was trying to run away. Look, I'm first to admit that I failed at protecting her. Yeah, I know that. But you're the reason why she was trying to leave home so bad and she ended up being hit by a fucking car. It was your own doing, Dad.
How dare you? Are you not man enough, not responsible enough to own up to your own actions like any decent human being would? Huh? Trying to blame your own father for your mistakes? Is this how you normally behave? What type of example were you actually setting for your sister anyway? You were supposed to be a role model for her!
Oh, bullshit, Dad! Role model? Really? You really want to talk about not being a good role model? Horseshit! You're the one that would come home from work and start fights with Mom in front of us! You're the one that goes out on the weekends and gets drunk rather than spending time with your kids! You're the one that constantly belittles me for any of my few accomplishments because they're never good enough for you or your expectations! So yeah, Dad, you killed her, not me! Miguela just got tired of living in a broken home, and now she's gone. Congratulations, Dad.
Get out! Get the hell out! And I'm not gonna tell you again. Leave this house immediately.
Dad!
Leave right now! And don't think twice about ever coming back to this freaking home. I don't want to ever see you again. Leave and never come back.
Me, Dad. I don't even know what to say, you know. I really miss you, son. You have no idea how much regret I have inside of me and how badly I wish I wouldn't have said the things that I said. I'm sorry, son. I honestly couldn't be more proud to call you my son. And I wish I could thank you in person for actually making me realize how much of a piece of shit father and a terrible husband I was. Wow. I honestly can't believe it's actually been 5 years since you've left. I bet you're all grown up and you're your own man now. Well, let me update you on what's been going on around the house. Let's see where your sister actually would have turned 11 years old yesterday. when you were that age, you were actually finally just learning how to ride your bike without training wheels. I don't know if you've heard, but let's see. Your mother finally left me. I'm pretty sure that wouldn't have been a surprise to you. You've probably seen that coming from a mile away. Listen, Sean, to be honest, I'm not even sure if you will ever get to hear this, or even if you've got the same phone number. But just know that I miss you, Sean, and I love you. Please come home.
It's okay, Dad. None of that matters now. I forgive you, and I'm sorry, too. It's just good to hear from you, Dad.
Oh, boy. Things really did get fucked up, didn't they?
Yeah, Dad. Yeah, they did.
I mean, how does a man stoop so low that he manages to push his son and everyone who cares for him out of his life?
And being too hard on yourself. Honestly, I was far from the perfect son. You were emotional, Dad. I mean, what man wouldn't be after having lost his daughter?
Sean, Mikayla would have been in her first year of high school. I still miss her to this day. She was my little girl.
Well, old man, I got some news that might soften that rock, hard, cold heart of yours, you bastard.
What are you talking about?
You're gonna be a grandpa.
What?
Yeah, Dad, I'm having a girl.
Wait, what? Sean, you just gave me my only wish. Like, Sean, I'm going to be a grandfather?
Listen. You still want me to come home? You get to see your granddaughter in 3 months.
Yes, Sean, yes. Come home. Son, I love you.
I love you too, Dad. I love you too.